Hi guys, welcome to my channel Cooking Diaries. Today I'm going to show you how to make perfect silky smooth textured fruit custard. It is an excellent treat to make during hot summer days and it is also a good choice to make for iftars during month of Ramadan. First I will show how to make custard powder at home, then we will move on to making our fruit custard. So without further delay, let's get started. To make custard powder at home, all we would need is half a cup of regular sugar, 1/4 cup of milk powder, 1/4 cup of corn starch, 1/8 teaspoon of yellow food color, 1 teaspoon of vanilla for flavoring. Now this would make a lot of custard powder, but we could save it in an airtight container for up to 6 to 8 months. Now we are basically going to add all of these ingredients to a mixer bowl and give it a quick mix. Now we're going to just sift all of this together. There we have it guys, smooth, soft custard powder made right at home. Again, as I said, we could save this in an airtight container and it would stay good for a good 6 to 8 months in a shelf. We don't even have to refrigerate it. Now that the custard powder is ready, let's move on to making our fruit custard. To make this fruit custard, we would need 1 liter or 4 cups of whole fat milk, half a cup of regular sugar, half a cup of the custard powder that we just made, and the rest of the ingredients here are totally up to your choice. We could use whatever fruits, dry fruits you like or you have on hand to make this fruit custard. I am using some pomegranate seeds, grapes, ripe mango, banana, apples, cherries, and also I'll be using some almond flakes, cashews. I want to talk a little bit about the mixed fruit essence here. This is an optional ingredient, but it does enhance the custard flavor further and takes this dish to the next level. If you have it or if you can find it, I do recommend using about 1/4 teaspoon of mixed fruit essence. But if you don't have it or if you cannot find it, don't worry, the custard is still going to be nice, smooth and creamy. So I'm going to take a cup of milk into a separate bowl and add our custard powder into it. Now give it a good mix until there are no lumps and all the custard powder is mixed well into the milk. Next, I have a pot here on medium heat. I'm going to add the rest of 3 cups of milk to it and let it come to a boil. Once the milk has come to a boil, reduce the flame to medium and add the sugar and mix it until the sugar is dissolved in the milk. Let's mix the custard powder and milk slurry and add it to the milk at this point. After cooking it for a few minutes, the milk would thicken up and it would look like a sauce. The easy way to tell whether it is ready or not is if you take the spoon and run your finger across. As you can see, the mixture won't come together. So this is a good sign that the milk mixture is thickened up and it is ready. So at this time, turn the heat off and let the milk mixture cool down for a few minutes and then put it in the refrigerator and let it chill down at least for a couple hours. Alright guys, while the custard was cooling down, I prepped my fruits and ready here. Try to cut your fruits just before you take the custard out of the fridge, because otherwise the fruits would turn black, which we don't want to happen. So just before we assemble our fruit custard, let's add about 1/4 teaspoon of mixed fruit essence to the custard and give it a good mix. Normally you would just add fruits to the custard and serve it, that would be it. But we are going to pour this into glasses and let them chill in the fridge for some more time. This not only makes it look much pretty, but it also tastes good once all the fruits are chilled and cold. So first pour a ladle full of custard to the bottom of the glass. Then add some fruits, banana, apple, mango, pomegranate seeds, grapes. Then add another ladle full of custard. Now add some dry fruit, more fruits, some more custard on top, finally some cherry, pomegranate seeds and some almond. Once arranged it in layers and topped it off with some dry fruits and fruits, I'm going to let this chill in the fridge for another hour and they're ready to enjoy. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Give me a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button so that I will see another video. Until then, bye.